Okay, we're live in 5, 4, 3.
Hello, folks, and welcome to the HQ of Formula One's newest team. We've been invited backstage to gain an exclusive insight into what could be one of the most exciting entries in the sport for many years. Now, we've seen a number of new teams enter the sport over the last decade, amongst their number Manor, Caterham, HRT, and of course, Haas. And while some have proved to be successful, others have morphed into different teams, and some have disappeared completely. What marks this team out, though, as being something different is that its owner is also its driver. Now, there's a rich history of that in Formula One too. Sir Jack Brabham, John Surtees, Graham Hill, and Bruce McLaren all drove their own cars in the sport, but it has become increasingly rare in recent years. What's very special about this team, though, is that, while the team itself is new to Formula One, so too is its driver and owner. Whatever happens this season, you've already made the history books. Tell me, do you feel up to the mammoth task of both managing and driving for a Formula One team? Every team needs two drivers, but what was it that drew you to your teammates? No one aims to finish bottom of the table. Who's the team you're aiming to beat? How are you expecting the car to feel out on track? The other teams now have years of experience, both on and off the track. How are you planning to catch up to them? Overtaking is a key part of this sport. How have you ensured that your car can take advantage of each opportunity that comes your way? And finally, which of your new departments are you most proud of? Well, that's about all we've got time for here. We will see how this fledgling team fares in its first Grand Prix.
Okay, great. Thank you. That's a wrap.
Great interview, boss. You nailed exactly what the team's been working on. When you've got time, check the R&D tree to see our current progress and where we think there's room for more. And while you're at it, why not take a stroll around HQ and check on how the team's doing? This is where you can view our current facilities and the effects they're having on the business. You can also invest some of our cash into upgrades for these facilities. it's important to use the time between races to the fullest extent, and that's where these activities come in. Manage everyone's time as efficiently as possible to maximize the team's performance. Hey boss, I think we could better manage our time by organising some team activities. Head to the activity screen to see what we have available.
morning, boss. Jeff here. Thanks again for bringing me on board. You've found a lot of talented people for this team. I can't wait to see what we can accomplish. Our journey to the Constructors' Championship starts here today, and the car is ready to head out whenever you are. So, we'd like to run the acclimatization program if you have a chance before qualifying. It'll give us a good indication of our relative pace and consistency. If you find yourself getting understeer, then you're not getting enough grip from the front. Out of fuel, you need to pit within the next two laps. Come in at the end of this lap. If you want to know specific information or make certain changes to the car during a pit stop, you can tell me what you want over the radio. Press and hold the radio button to activate the system, and you can either speak the command or select it manually from the radio screen that will appear on the multifunction display. While the radio is active, cycle through command groups with the MFD button. We're top of the speed trap, 203.0 miles per hour. This is a quali sim. We've estimated the times our closest rivals will be doing, so that's what we need to beat. Job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can talk you through the numbers. Program. test complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that. Through a lap, so try to keep the wear down through each corner. Be especially careful accelerating on corner exit. Job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can talk you through the numbers.
The session has drawn to a close, so let's...
this program, we want you to focus on fuel-saving technique. Lift and coast through corner entry to save as much as you can while keeping under the minimum lap time. Decent lap there, but there's still more to find. Keep at it. So far, our fastest lap is a 1:34.7.
It's time to remind ourselves of our top three, who are Albon, Hamilton, and Sir. We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Hamilton, Rees, and Charles Leclerc. With qualifying complete, all that remains is the main event. We'll be live and uninterrupted for the Grand Prix tomorrow, so make sure you join us then.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Rees completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Leclerc, Vettel, Alexander Albon, and Bottas, Verstappen, Ricciardo, Sainz, and Sergio Perez, Stroll, Kvyat, Lando Norris, and Ocon, Gasly, Raikkonen, Kevin Magnussen, and Antonio Giovinazzi, Russell, Joe, Grosjean, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
This is your final lap, of the race. First position, front of the pack. Leclerc behind. The gap is less than a second. They're on old softs. This is your final lap. Final lap of the race. Fantastic. You've won the Grand Prix.
Smiling faces on the pit wall after a superb win here at Sakhir. And rightly so. What a brilliant effort from the whole team. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.